So you sell a high ticket coaching or freelance package, and you even booked a discovery or strategy call. So what do you do next? That's exactly what we're going to talk about today. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Alan, and on this channel, we talk all things about how to book more discovery calls and more clients. Now, today, we are talking about how to run a live discovery call, or strategy call, or clarity call, or whatever you want to call it. So today, we're actually going to focus half on the actual running the call and the other half on the script, which is obviously part of running the call itself. So I'll go ahead and assume that you've already prepared for your high ticket discovery call, like in my video here. So the first way to run your next discovery call is to build trust. Now, some people refer to this as building rapport, building trust, and there's actually, I've seen a lot of different rules about this. Some people say build rapport for 3 minutes before the rest of your script. I actually have found it that the shorter the amount of period is generally better. So the short story here that I personally suggest is to build rapport or trust at least immediately. And for about 30 seconds max. Two great ways of doing this are by focusing on being unique and relevant. So for example, you don't really build much rapport by saying, oh, the weather is XYZ, or oh, the Olympics, or whatever the popular trends are, XYZ. You want to actually relate to them and make them feel that you are similar to them and that you understand them, even if it's kind of irrelevant. So if you can, I've already mentioned about research before, try to find out what their hometown is, what their home state is, what their politics are, pretty much anything like that, so that you can build some quick, immediate, and deep rapport or trust with them right at the beginning of your call. A few other ways you can do this are by using video in your call, which I always suggest using video as much as possible. And on top of that, being extremely enthusiastic and having conviction in your sales pitch. The next step to run your discovery call is to set your agenda. So right after you said, oh, this is your hometown, oh, this is your dog, oh, this is your business or whatever, then you want to set the tone and establish the agenda for the rest of your call. So there's actually a few different ways of doing this, but the simplest way would be to say something like this. So my discovery calls usually run 20 to 25 minutes where we can help you X, Y, and Z. So if you noticed there, that sounds very innocent and polite, but notice how I made it clear how long this is going to take, what our purpose is here for, but most importantly, it sets yourself as the person running the call. So if you get on the call and if your prospect immediately starts saying, well, what do you do this? What's the price for this? What do you think this? Then they are the ones running the call, which is not the situation you're looking for. The next step to run high ticket discovery calls is to take notes. Now, I've talked about this a lot before, that your goal here is essentially to repeat back the answers that they have already given you. So you want to ask them questions like, what are your fears? What are your problems? What are your obstacles? Now, you probably already know what those things are, but the important thing here is to hear it in their words. Now, trust me, I know how easy it is to tell yourself, oh, I'll remember what they said. Oh, I'll remember what their arguments were, what their objections were, and so forth. But the short story is that you won't remember. So there is extreme value for a million reasons aside from just this one to take notes. And if you can, record the call. Because remember, one of the best ways to sell anything to anyone, let alone something high ticket, is to ask them what they want and to literally repeat it back to them when elaborating on the benefits of your offer. The next step to run high ticket discovery calls is to build trust. Now, I've made entire videos about this, including this one up above, but the point is that there are actually more than 20 ways to build trust and authority even if you're in a new niche. Now, there's actually a ton of ways to build trust. And since there's more than 20, I'll go ahead and just read off some of these that I have listed here. So a few ways you can build trust are to borrow the trust from somebody else. You can establish or emphasize the longevity of your business. You can share affinity, which means like similar interests or background. You can specify how strict of a niche or ideal customer or client you are looking for. You can have a strict price and offer. You can have a expansive content library. You can customize your offer. You can admit your flaws. And that's literally only half of the ways to build trust. But the point is that no matter what you sell, you sell trust. Literally, if you sell widgets, services, coaching, Amazon FBA, literally whatever you sell, the number one thing you're really selling is trust to solve a problem. So that's what we're talking about here. The next step to run a high ticket discovery call is to shut up, listen, and empathize and understand what your lead is saying. Now, I've said before that this step seems like the easiest step. Now, when I talk to people, they say, just don't talk and listen. That's the easiest thing I've ever heard. Why doesn't everybody do this? Blah, 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 blah. I'm not really sure why they don't, but the fact is they don't. This means don't just wait for your chance to say your story. Don't just wait for the chance to blah, 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 literally to talk. Your goal here is to let them speak at least 70% of the time. So you're looking for their problems, their obstacles, their goals, whatever it might be, just so that you can repeat it back to them in your offer and benefits. So I'll go ahead and repeat this one more time just to make sure that I cement this idea enough. Actually, I have a good example. So I'm actually hiring, I hire a lot of people on Upwork for a lot of random reasons. But the point is, right now, I'm looking for a graphic designer to pretty up a workbook. Now, if I'm going to be honest, pretty much all 15 of the graphic designers that I have shortlisted can probably do the job I'm looking for at a pretty good price and do a pretty good job. But the people that I'm willing to pay extra for and that I trust more are the people who say they are workbook designers, calendar designers, planner designers. Now, does this mean that they are better than the other graphic designers? To be honest, probably not. But because they empathize with my situation, because they understand me, because they are listening to my exact problem, not only am I willing to hire them, I'm actually willing to pay more for the privilege. The next step to run high-ticket discovery calls is to accept the fact that you are selling high ticket. That means high value and much more. Now, there are definitely rules that apply to all sales. However, selling to the wealthier market or to the high ticket market, pretty much anybody willing to spend over $2,000 for whatever you're selling is a different ballgame, which you at least have to know the rules for, and obviously you should play by them as well. So there's actually a lot more into this than I have time to discuss now, and if you want to learn more about it, then definitely check out Daniel Priestley's book, Oversubscribed, here or in the links below. But in any case, you should know and accept that high ticket buyers or a wealthier audience responds differently than, let's just say, the standard audience will. So the main way that this happens is that they actually don't want a yes man or somebody who just agrees with them. So this is actually, I'm going to go ahead and suggest a secondary book, which is The Challenger Sale, which I will put up here. But the point is that modern buyers, they don't want somebody to just say, oh, thank you. Oh, you're so smart. Oh, you're so great. Yeah, everything you want is great. No, they actually want somebody to tell them, yeah, what you want is this, but what you actually need is this. So I am definitely not saying to disrespect your leads or prospects, but what I am telling you is that more affluent, wealthier, higher ticket audiences, they don't want yes people to just tell them that they are great and they are right and they are so smart, because they know they aren't. all of us know we aren't. Actually, I just invested over $5,000 in coaching recently, and one of the main reasons is because on the sales call, the girl told me, oh, well, you want this? Nah, you want this. Now, to be fair, some people will respond totally different to this. Some people would say, I'm right. You don't know what I want. You don't tell me what to do. Meh, 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 meh. Okay, that's fair. But most of the people that react that way don't have the money to spend at the price point that you are looking to sell at. The next step to any sale or to a high ticket discovery call is to close or to make the sale. So obviously, this includes actually pitching your offer. You want to let them know what your offer is, how they can get it, and what the next steps to move forward are. So if you've seen any of my previous videos, then you know I am a huge fan of rubber meeting the road. That means your offer or your business rubbing up against the market. So you want to maximize this rubbing against each other. You want your offer to smack against the market. You want to know what their feedback is, what their suggestions are, what their conversion rate is, pretty much everything like that. So as always, I'm actually making another video on closing soon. The point here to any sales, but let alone a high ticket discovery call, is to focus on their result. So this means don't focus on whatever your delivery vehicle is. The next step to run your discovery calls is to book the next meeting. So as you would imagine that this is more useful for the prospects that reject your main offer, but whether they do or not, this can be an extremely useful step to take advantage of. So whether they buy or not, you definitely want to lock them into your next meeting. Obviously, especially if not, but you get the point here. And the absolute most important thing you can do to run high ticket discovery calls is to hit the like button and subscribe below. If you learned something interesting today, it does help a lot. For more help booking high ticket discovery calls and clients, book a free strategy call with me below to find the opportunities in your business. Well, that wraps us up for today. Thanks everyone for stopping by, and I'll see you on the next one.